What's up, y'all? This is your boy, DJ BJ Clark, with the After Work Drive Show, right here on 104.5 WRFU. I want to invite you to tune in every Tuesdays and Thursdays at 5 p.m. for the After Work Drive Show with your boy, DJ BJ Clark.
You're listening to the After Work Drive Show with DJ BJ Clark.
As you guys know, throughout the weeks, we'll be doing these series of interviews with a lot of wonderful artists. Now, they could be mainstream artists. They could be from our community right here in Champaign-Urbana. They could also be anywhere around the world. With that being said,
let's go ahead and make that call, shall we? We shall. We shall. Oh, I love this part of the show. I really, truly do.
Hello, this is Zaina.
Hey, Zaina, what's going on? It's your boy, DJ BJ Clark, and you are live on the After Work Drive Show right here on 104.5. How are you?
I'm good. I'm super excited and glad you called me. I've been waiting for you.
Oh, well, I want to thank you for waiting patiently. So thank you so much. Thank you. And
you're very welcome.
Where are you calling from today?
I am actually in Orlando, Florida.
Orlando, Florida. So it's about 6:54 there, huh?
Yes, and it's extremely hot. I was actually listening to your weather report, and we're going through that heat wave here. I mean, I don't know what the summer is going to bring because it's already scorching hot.
It's already 100 degrees. That's right. That's right. Let me ask you this question. What kind of music do you like to listen to?
What kind of music do I listen to? Well, my tastes really span the globe. So I grew up listening to international music. Mm-hmm. So I love Latin music. That's like my favorite nighttime activities, salsa and bachata.
All right.
I'm also Middle Eastern. So I love me some Arabic music. I listen to some pop, R&B. A little bit of hip-hop, trance. I mean, pretty much everything that's pleasant to my ear and that makes me dance. And then some international stuff, too, like Greek music's pretty cool, Turkish music. I mean, I have, like, 9 different languages in my car.
Wow. 9 different languages? That's incredible.
Yes.
That's incredible.
Yeah, too bad I don't speak them, but, you know, I only speak 3. Mm. Well, 2.5, English, Arabic, and a little bit of Spanish.
Well, there you go. That's good. Yeah. Let me ask you this question. What style of music would you classify your music? And, what kind of music do you make?
So, basically, I like to be very versatile. Like, it's very hard for me to stick to one thing. So, the best way that I can describe my music is that it's a fusion of sounds. So it's a little bit of pop, a little bit of dance, and a little bit of whatever I feel inspired by at the time.
Okay. Now, your stage name is?
Well, it's actually my real name. My name is Zaina with a Z, like zebra. And that's the name I was born with, and that's the name that I use.
That's a good, beautiful name, actually, Zaina.
Thank you.
But honestly, how can the fans that we have listening here, I know we have thousands and thousands of folks tuning in, and I want them to be able to get to know you as we're sitting here hanging out on 104.5 WRFU. Do you have like social media, like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, anything that people can just learn more?
Yes, definitely, definitely. I have all of it. I mean, it's hard to keep up with, but I like to be everywhere. I like to cater to every platform. My main account is Instagram, and you can find me at only the number one and Zaina with a Z like zebra. It's all one word, only one Zaina. Mm-hmm. My links to my music are there as well and to my other socials. I'm also on Facebook, TikTok, YouTube, Twitter, Spotify, of course, all the streaming platforms. So, definitely check me out. I have a lot of great things coming. I support independent talent. So you can discover new music. You might be inspired to dance a little. You'll definitely laugh a little. So definitely come by and say hi.
All right. And you also have a YouTube page as well, YouTube channel. And that is Only One Zaina on YouTube too, right?
Yes, I tried to make it super easy by having it be only one Zaina everywhere.
That's cool.
But yeah,
That's
I tried to make it super easy.
I just had somebody just ask me, how long have you been making music for?
So basically, music is something I've always wanted to do. But, you know, opportunities kind of took me in a different direction. So it's been about over a year now. I'm pretty late to the game, but better late than never, right?
Right. Oh, it's never, never too late. It's
right.
never
and,
too
and I,
late.
I can't imagine my life without music now. I'm like, why didn't I do this sooner? But I released my first single in June of 2021.
The first single in June of 2021. Now, how many songs would you say that you have in your catalog?
Well, so far I have four. I just released one on June 9th, The Sky's the Limit, which is I'm hoping you're going to play it today so people can take a listen. But I have four songs now.
What's the new single? What's the new single that's out right now?
So the new single is called Sky is the Limit.
Uh-huh.
And fun fact, it's actually the first song I ever wrote.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, but it was never released. We decided to release other songs first. And I loved that song so much that I just wanted to put it out there. So the time was right, and I just released it on June 9th.
That's cool. That's cool. Will you hear voices by any chance?
Yes,
you
I
do.
Have voices as well.
What kind of voices do you hear?
Oh, do I hear voices? No.
She said, yeah, I hear voices.
I mean, I hear voices in my head that tell me all kinds of stuff. But no, not those kind of voices.
I
so, yes, I do have a song called Voices.
Yeah.
And Voices is basically about like your internal struggle as well as just all the thoughts and criticism and just everything that you hear that you want to hear and you don't want to hear from
right.
your outside world, along with the thoughts in your head that
right.
you know keep on pushing you or discouraging you or encouraging you. So that's what Voices is all about. It's just about pushing forward and
so
knowing.
would you say that's a motivational kind of song?
Definitely, yes.
Yeah. So collectively, to answer that, thank you. It's actually Cindy. Cindy, thank you for sending in that question about how many years have you been doing music? So you would say like what, 1 or 2 years you've been doing music for?
Yeah, a little over 1 year. Like professionally releasing singles, a little over 1 year. I've been singing forever, but music, definitely a little over 1 year.
Another question from Cindy. She's actually really listening and she's tuned in. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Cindy.
Yes, let's thank Cindy for tuning in. And questions. So she asks right here is, whenever, what made you make the leap into getting into music and why? Why did you make this leap?
Well, I'm very glad you asked that because it's actually an interesting story. So like I said, it's always been something I wanted to do, but I grew up in Los Angeles, California, so I had a couple of opportunities that I missed because I was just focused on the wrong things, is the best way I can put it. So I repressed that dream. And then one day during the beginning months of the COVID pandemic, believe it or not, I had a lot of time on my hands. I was transitioning into my other dream of self-employment, and I happened to meet my first manager Friday. Shout out to Friday the driver. We got talking about music, and he's very passionate about music. He's been in the music industry forever. So he actually kept pushing me to get the ball rolling on making some music. And that's when I finally released my first single in June 2021.
Wow. And the first single, what was the name of that one?
That was No One Knows. It's
No
called
One
No One Knows.
Okay.
It's always going to be my baby. You know, it's my first one that I released.
Mm-hmm.
It was the second song I ever wrote. But yes.
But since Cindy's listening and she asked those wonderful questions, can we check out No One Knows right here on 104.5 WRFU right now?
Oh, yes, definitely.
All right. Well, do you want to introduce this song for everybody that's listening?
Yes. Hi, my name is Zaina, and this is my first single called No One Knows at 104.5.
You're listening to the After Work Drive Show with DJ BJ Clark.
No one knows anything. amazing. Someone I used to know now just feels like a stranger. Lie on fold, truth be told, hers but it feels amazing. Someone I used to know now just feels like a stranger. Cause no one
Zaina.
Yes, I'm
love it. Love it.
No but I'm one... most importantly, what did Cindy think? Is she still on with us?
I guess she'll chime in later.
Thank you, Cindy? Thank you for playing that. I always love that song. So it's
what's
my first.
Cindy? I'm sure she'll chime in here in a little bit, but I hope she did like it. No one knows anything. I think it's really what I love about that song right there. It's the message, you know?
Yes.
It's like saying, yeah, and it's, that's a good message.
Well, and it's definitely kind of talking about, it's talking about just leaving things behind that don't serve you and mm-hmm. following what does serve you. Because at the end of the day, you go through that experience, but just no one knows what's going to happen. So you need to just kind of follow whatever feels light and just, you know, I know it's bittersweet, but kind of leave what doesn't really align with your life. So that's what No One Knows was about. It's like a mix of thoughts about that.
Could you give us a brief description on your music making process?
Yes. So basically, as far as lyrical, I kind of just write notes as they come to me because, you know, with lyrics, it's mm-hmm. just you never know when they're gonna come. You know, sometimes you're driving, sometimes it's at 4 a.m, mm-hmm. sometimes you're working. So I kind of just take them on a notepad on my phone and just keep them there. And then when it's time to put a song together, I usually get inspired by a story or a thought, or I mean, it could be anything, an argument that I hear or whatever it is, it just inspires me so much that I decide to make a song about it. Then I just take all my lyrical notes and put mm-hmm. them all together.
That's cool.
And create something inspired by that thought, scenario, mm-hmm. or that argument. And I record at my local studio, Lion okay. House Music.
What's the name of it?
Lion House Music.
Lion House Music. And that's there in Orlando, Florida?
That's in Kissimmee, yeah. It's about 20 minutes away. It's he's a good friend of mine. It's a local studio. It's a home studio. So I go and record there, and then he mixes and masters it for me. The sky's the limit I worked on with the online recording studio, so I work with different producers.
Yeah, can you talk about that real quick, the online recording studio?
Yeah, so they've been amazing, actually. This is Sky's the Limit is the first song that they've produced for me, and definitely we have more in the pipeline. But basically, I gave them the song, and then we sat down with the producer. We had a few sessions, and we created the beat that we wanted that sounds the best with the song. And I mean, they did an amazing job all the way through, and we came up with an amazing track. So
that's pretty sweet. And you want to know, I want to hear it. I want to hear the song.
Yes. Yes, yes, definitely. Sky's the limit. It's my
latest. Now that you said it like that, you sold it pretty good. But before we play the Sky's the Limit, all right? Mm-hmm. Can you give me the symbolism behind Sky's the Limit?
Yes, definitely. So basically, to tell you the story of Sky's the Limit, so it was the first, it marks really the beginning of my music career, because it was the first song I ever wrote. So basically, with Sky's the Limit, I was really documenting my commitment to the music journey, because I finally took it upon myself and committed to music, or was documenting my future commitment anyway. Mm-hmm. And I knew that there was going to be challenges. I knew that there was going to be ups and downs. I had fears, a lot of fears, you know, performing live and doing this and the work involved and just all these moving parts. But I told myself that just sky's the limit. It's an opportunity. I'm finally going to be living my dream, and I'm going to do it no matter what.
Do you feel the sky is the limit as of right now? Do you feel like you're flying high?
Oh, yes, because, you know, it's all about the journey, right? So regardless of where we end up and how far we go, the journey has been amazing. I mean, I've learned so much about myself. I've been blessed to run into the right people to guide me on this journey and believe in me and see my vision. It's been amazing. I've learned about myself more than I've probably learned my whole life in this one year because of the music. There's so many, it's challenging in a great way, put it that way.
That's sweet. And, how long did it take you making Sky's the Limit? What was the, I guess you could say the time frame behind it?
Well, Sky's the Limit, I mean, I wrote it back in, I would say February of like 2021, February, March of 2021. And it kind of just, I recorded it. It actually was recorded under a different beat, a slower beat. And it was kind of meant to be like a practice song. If I have to be honest, it was like my first one ever. It was just me learning all the ins and outs. So it was done under a different beat. And then we kind of released other stuff. And then I came to the point where I just felt like I wanted to release that. It documents my music journey. You know, it's just song.
Yeah, it's a piece of work.
So that's when I decided to renew the music and, you know, collaborated with the online recording studio. I didn't change the lyrics. Those are original. But we just kind of remade the song and gave it a little bit of a faster beat that just fit well.
Now, are they able to check this song out on Spotify?
Oh, yes, definitely. So if they go to my social media, I have my links. I have a link in my bio in every social media, and it's going to have all my streaming platforms. So they can go directly to that and follow me on Spotify or Apple Music or Amazon, and you can hear all my music there.
Sweet, sweet, sweet. Now, are there any special thank yous, individuals, actually, that you would like to thank for the inspiration behind this song, Sky's the Limit?
I mean, the first person that comes to mind is definitely my first manager, Friday. He goes by Friday the Driver. I mean, I definitely owe everything to him, because if it wasn't for him, I would have never started. We're still amazing friends, and he's just been supportive all the way through. And he's just very passionate about music and artists. And so shout out to him for sure. And we're still really good friends.
He still
helps me out. We collaborate on a lot of stuff. So he's been an amazing friend.
Is he listening right now?
I hope so. Well, I told him to listen.
I believe he is. I believe he's listening. And Friday the Driver, we appreciate you. Big shout out to Friday the Driver.
And yes, definitely. And the second, of course, the online recording studio, the whole team, everyone's been amazing. Joe, Savannah, Dan, the producer. I mean, they gave me this amazing beat. They actually brought my vision to life with Sky's the Limit. So, and they're still supporting me until today. So definitely shout out to them as well.
That's what's up.
And lastly, my mom. If I have to think of one person that's definitely been my biggest fan and supported me all the way through, it would be my mom. I mean, and my friends, of course. But my mom was just there every step of the way. You know, she heard all my rants about music. She heard all my drafts. She's just supported me in every way possible. So shout out to her.
That's what's up. Well, Zaina, do you want to go ahead and release this song right here for the very first time for thousands and thousands of people to listen to live on 104.5 WRFU, the Afterwork Drive show?
Yes, I would be more than happy to. Hello, everyone. My name is Zaina, and you're about to hear my latest single, Sky is the Limit. I hope you take it with you on your journey to remind you that possibilities are endless, and you're listening on 104.5 FM.
Fantastic. That is good. The sky is the limit for sure.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
I told you. It's the messages behind the songs. It's the lyrics. Like, where do you come up with these lyrics?
So I got to tell you, like, I'm a glass half full kind of a person. I mean, we all go through struggles and we all have lows and we all have bad moments. But for me, it's like every time I sing, every time I write a song, I want to kind of write about the light at the end of the tunnel. I don't want to go dark and deep. You know, I want to go deep, but not dark. I want to go deep and light. So, right. So that's just me. That's just how I am. That's how I talk. That's how I live life. So
I'm sure you probably, I'm sure you get this all the time when people hear you for the very first time, but you, do you know you kind of sound like Jennifer Lopez?
Oh my God, I get that all the time.
I knew it, but that's really like, you favor J-Lo.
Well, when J-Lo. I talk, I've heard that when I talk, so people on the phone always tell me I sound like
no,
J-Lo.
For real though, for real.
You and sound you know, I'm like not Puerto her. Rican, and I'm not from New York. Like, you know, they tell me that I sound like I'm from New York, but I've never lived in New York at all. So,
wow, it's a great voice, great voice. What is your main goal in your music career moving forward from this single?
So basically, you know, right now I'm still pretty new. So I have a couple of local performances in the works. Mm-hmm. However, I'm like mainly just focused on building a catalog of music and just connecting with my audience online. Mm-hmm. Obviously, it's just a lot of things coming. So I'm just living day by day and tackling these obstacles as they come to me and just growing, basically. I have another single coming up in about 8 weeks.
Okay.
I also have a couple of series for Instagram Live and YouTube. And I just started an amazing independent music playlist on Spotify to support independent artists and give back to the music community.
Can you give them the link? Can we get a link for that?
It's in my bio. It's on Spotify. So if they follow me on Spotify, my playlist is right there. It's called Indie Vibes, Discover New Music.
Okay.
I update that often, and I support all these independent artists on my social media as well as on Spotify because, you know, it takes a lot of hard work, and there's some massive talent out there that's just not being heard.
That's right. So. That is true. Now, let me ask you this. What would you say separates you from other artists if you had to separate yourself?
What separates me from other artists is basically that I want to say that I can't stick to one thing. I have a high drive for creativity, and I'm always looking to outdo myself. Mm-hmm. And I'm always looking to create something different, and just be out of the box. So I'm always looking to fusion sounds together and just experiment with different things. And I just always want something different and refreshing. So if I had to say, I would say that, because I just cannot stick to the same thing for the life of me.
And that's okay. That's all right. Let me ask you this question. What skills have you learned so far, and what skills have you learned that will help you in your music career and your singing career moving forward too?
So I've learned a lot. For one, I've learned to put myself out there and step out of my comfort zone, because I put myself out there on social media every day.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't start this way because I was never a fan of social media until I actually started doing music and connecting with audiences and realized how amazing it can be for that. So I'm a lot more comfortable in front of the camera now.
That's cool. That's great.
And I've also learned, I mean, it's definitely been a confidence boost performing. Yes. And just making music and releasing that creative energy. And I've just learned so much about myself, you know.
Yeah.
I've learned to not hold back and just keep pushing. And even if something is scary or something is, you know, you don't know what's going to happen, it's unknown, you just kind of throw yourself at it and see what happens. And it always ends up amazing on the other side, you know.
Now, if you had to, like, study another songwriter, singer, or just, you know, just a singer out there to study under, who would you desire to study under?
There are so many amazing ones, but the one that's off the top of my head,
uh-huh,
would be Sia.
Sia?
Sia, yes. I just feel like her music is just, it just makes me go places in my head, and I love that. I get intrigued by everything that she does as, mm-hmm, far as music. She has a versatility in her music that I truly appreciate. And as a person, when I do see her on TV, I don't see her live, but as an individual, I feel like she's very authentic. And that's something I truly appreciate, because it's kind of a rare commodity nowadays, unfortunately.
So
her songwriting skills, I mean, you know, she's written some really amazing songs and always motivational. So I love that.
That is cool. That is great. Once again, I know we've been talking about your social media, but what's your favorite part about social media? And as well as, how do you feel that social media has changed the music industry?
My favorite part about social media would have to be being able to express myself and just share my life and my journey with everyone, with the world, reaching out to the world, basically, and sharing my message and inspiring others through that. I think social media is definitely a game changer for music, because when we were growing up, we didn't have social media. Now you can just put your music on social media and it could reach millions in like a second.
That's right. That's right. That's true.
It's an amazing outlet in every way.
Your music really does kind of identify your who you are. I can hear that now. As I was previewing some of your tracks, you do have a lot of dance style music, which is fun. Which is fun. I love it. Yes. I love dance music.
Well, I love to dance. So.
Let me ask you this. Dancing, all right, this could be dancing and performing. Have you performed anywhere? And if you have, where's your favorite place to perform? And also, for dancing right there where you are, what's one of your favorite places to go dance at?
So basically, I've performed locally in, a couple of, like, local bars, some events like open mic events and whatnot, and I'm barely starting out, so right now my focus is really connecting with my audience and just performing at the local spots and some local events. As far as dancing, my favorite style of dancing, I dance everything, but my favorite is salsa and bachata.
Oh, nice.
And my favorite place to dance would have to be Salsa Heat Studios. They have a social every Friday. It's amazing. I go there and meet everyone and dance. So shout out to them as well.
That's so much fun. Every Friday, huh?
Yes. I don't go every Friday because I can't always make it. But when I can, I do go and I just get my dance fix, you know.
That's cool. I love the dance, too. I love the dance. And dancing's fun. And it's also great exercise. Great just to move the body, you know.
Well, and it's amazing release too. Singing, dancing, I mean, all these things. I think everyone needs to incorporate something like that in their lives.
Oh yeah.
Because it's just an amazing release. I mean, you just feel like life is so much better when you dance or sing or travel, you know.
Now, out of the four or five songs that you have created, what would you say is the most challenging song and why?
The most challenging song to sing or
to write, to record, get in the studio. Maybe you just couldn't lay that one part down just quite right. Maybe the engineer just was having a bad day. Was there some trials and tribulations, some ups and downs?
I mean, definitely with all of them. But if I had to pick one off the top of my head, I would say Voices, because I probably did, like, I don't know how many versions of that just did not work. And then finally, I think it took me like maybe 5 months, 5 or 6 months to actually finish that track. So I just kept doing different versions of the story, and it just was not working for whatever reason. But we kept working it and then came up with, you know, the version that we have now. It just sounds amazing.
It is amazing. It is. Now, and also, what is it about your passion behind music, and what makes you feel so passionate about music?
Your questions are getting harder, you know?
My apologies. What? I mean, that's what I do. I ask questions. This is what I do.
No, I'm just messing with you. What makes me passionate, I mean, the thing that I love about music is that the creativity is just endless, basically. And I'm a very creative person. I have a thirst for creativity in everything that I do. I'm a real estate agent, and I still need some creativity in my real estate business. So that's what it satisfies, and it's like the only thing that fulfills that.
That's cool.
And, you know, with music, you can just go every single direction. You can create. So what I love most about music is just putting it together, just that creative process and coming up with something amazing that you can hear later.
Speaking of amazing, how does it feel whenever you have a friend over, maybe you're riding around in the car, or maybe you're at a barbecue or something, and you play your song? And how does it feel to watch other people listen to your music and your songs? Do you get nervous when people are about to listen to your song? You're like, oh, here we go.
I do. And, I always get in my head. That's just something natural, I think, for every artist and for everything, really, that you do in life. When you create something, you get in your head. That's something we all need to work on.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes I'm not sure how, if they like it or if they don't, but the most important thing is you keep creating, and there's audience for everything.
Let me ask you this. What's your process for dealing with performance and anxiety? And just what do you do when you have a moment like that? And you're like, how do you deal with that anxiety?
I fake it till I make it.
Hey, ain't nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with faking it till you make it.
But basically, you just have to throw yourself at it. I mean, like, I was nervous. I still have nerves when I perform.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still trying to perfect my performance skills to where the nerves don't get the best of me. But I just go out there. I give it my best shot, and I always do better every single time. And that's all you can do. Eventually, you will just succeed your level, you know?
That's what's up. Great answer. Great answer.
Thank you. I'm trying.
Zaina, you're doing a fantastic job. Only one Zaina. Is there an onlyonezaina.com?
No, not yet, but I do have all my links everywhere. So only the number one Zaina. And I want to tell the listeners, if you guys follow me, or when you follow me, shoot me a message.
Okay.
Let me know what you're up to. I love connecting with my audience. And most importantly, tell me how I did. I'd love to know how I did.
And let's give them another song to listen to, Zaina. So if you could, introduce Voices right here on 104.5 WRFU.
Hello, this is Zaina once again, and you're about to listen to one of my singles called Voices on 104.5 FM.
Point blank speaks.
gentlemen, that was Zaina. Zaina. Sorry, Zaina.
It's okay.
Amazing. I actually really liked the visuals on that video. Who made
yes.
that video for you?
I did, actually. Well, what happened, it's a funny story. I actually shot the music video with one of my photographers, but the data got corrupted, so I had to kind of create on the spot.
Yeah,
and,
to fill it in. It was fantastic.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yes, I'm creative in more than one way, you know. I'm blessed to be able to kind of, you know, work under pressure and get something going when needed.
That song is cool too. It's a cool song. And
I'm glad you like it.
Definitely. You can hear that right here on 104.5 WRFU like every day. That's how I love that song. I like that song.
I'm so glad to hear that. Yeah, that's like my latest release before, prior to Sky's the Limit. That was my newest one.
Voices is, that's amazing.
Thank you.
I'm going to give you a thumbs up, 10 stars, and fantastic. Keep that going. And it's got a great beat. The lyrics are great. The vocals are outstanding. Okay. Great vocals. You did a great job. And what I also love about, you guys got to see this on YouTube, but you put the lyrics on there.
Yes, I did put the lyrics in the description. I usually try to do a lyric video, but if I cannot do a lyric video, mm-hmm. then I try to put them in the description so people can kind of learn and sing
yeah.
along.
Very nice. Very nice. I like that. Just, you know, you did your due diligence on that song, on just how to, you released it. It was great. Good job.
Yes,
good
and job. Shout out to Point Blank Beats for that beautiful
yeah.
beat.
Yeah, one more time, guys, for being phenomenal. Okay?
Thank you.
That's
you're
the
so
truth.
Sweet.
That is cool. Good stuff. Let me ask you this. Moving forward, are you trying to sign under a record label? Is that the ultimate deal? Is that what you're going for?
That would be a nice goal if it were to go that direction. But of course, I would have to explore the different options because I'm even happy just making music, you know, and connecting with fans and just sharing my vision. But if I were to be approached by a record label, of course, I would not say no after I review everything.
Totally. Now, my next question is, when it's all said and done, the ultimate direction that you're going, are you seeking fame and fortune?
I don't know if I'm seeking fame and fortune. Fame and fortune would definitely be nice and a plus. But regardless of what happens, I'm nowhere where I want to be, of course. But regardless of what happens, I'm just enjoying the journey day by day. I'm living my dream, which is the most important thing ever. I finally got started.
Well, that's so amazing. That's yeah.
That is all that matters. At the end of the day, whatever happens, I'm going to, you know, take it and just run with it.
Now, I guess biggest challenges so far and how did you overcome them? All right. And then I would like for you to go into maybe giving advice to somebody wanting to jump into music like you did. Doesn't matter what age you are, doesn't matter where you are in life, doesn't matter if you don't have, you know, a full-blown on studio. What advice would you give somebody that is emerging into the music business or just wanting to become a more of a singer-songwriter like yourself? What advice would you give someone?
Right. So first, I'll talk about the obstacles or challenges. So with everything, there comes many challenges. So I'm still tackling them every day, honestly. Mm-hmm. But there's just so many moving parts to creating music that you don't realize until you get started. Same with performing your music. There's even more moving parts to that. So some of the challenges I've had, like, you know, learning to work with my vocal range, finding a producer that believes in me and kind of sees my vision and has my best interest, mm-hmm. and, you know, learning to work with different kinds of mics, believe it or not, just little things that you would not you'd not be able to think of. And of course, perfecting your performance on stage and not letting the nerves get to you. But the way I overcome all of that is I just keep going. I keep creating. I keep pushing myself out of my comfort zone. Mm-hmm. And I do it with a smile on my face, regardless. Now, as far as advice, what I would give to other artists is basically, first of all, don't get stuck on perfect, because that doesn't exist. This is something I'm working on still. Okay. So I'm going to take my own advice. And also, just make time to do what you love. It is life-changing.
Yes.
And most importantly, remain authentic. You know, that's, like I said, a rare commodity nowadays and very appreciated. And lastly, I would tell them, just give others mad love and support on their ventures, especially if they do the same thing.
That's right. Because that's right.
They'll support you right back.
That's right. Yes, they will. And I'm a firm believer in that. You have to support one another and got to lift each other up. That is so true.
Dead on. Just put yourself out there. You know, put yourself out there on social media, like whatever you need to do. Just like I said, don't get stuck. I mean, I'm having a hard time living good enough alone, but it's something that I work on every single day.
Okay, well, do you also work on dancing too?
Yes, when I have time, because now, you know, I'm doing so many different things. I'm being pulled in different directions. Real estate is still my main job, although music is starting to take over.
That's good. That's good.
Yes, yes. So when I have time, I go dance. I take a couple of classes. You know, I learn on YouTube. I mean.
Well, could we do all of our listeners a favor? And can we play them one of your Dance All Night songs?
Yes. It's actually called Dance All Night, yes. And that song is also warm to my heart, because little backstory.
Yeah, talk COVID about was, it. Talk about it. Let's hear it.
Yes. When COVID was happening, I couldn't dance for 2 years because of everything that was happening, and we didn't know what to believe and whatnot. And we couldn't be close to other people. And, you know, Latin dancing, you got to dance with a partner.
Yep.
So that's where that song emerged. Like, I started missing those nights where you just go dance all night, and I just wanted to give people something they could listen to and feel like they're there again, you know? So that's the story with Dance All Night.
Introduce the song for everyone right here in Central Illinois.
This is Zaina, and you're about to hear Dance All Night, one of my favorite singles, on 104.5 FM.
Let's go!
Girls and I, we don't need you. Moving up and down.
Dance All Night.
Yes, yes, yes. We had to document the song about dancing. You know, I had to do it.
I'm a firm. I love dancing. I love dancing. I really do. I love dancing, and I love dance music. And your tunes are just uplifting, upbeat, and that's the kind of music we need, you know, especially
here.
Yes,
I think every single person should take up dancing or try to dance or make it part of their life. Like, it's life-changing, like everything else.
Brings so much joy to your heart, doesn't it? Just to get out there and move a little, dance a little. It almost feels like the sky's the limit when you're dancing.
Right, and you're also detoxing, you know? Let's not forget that.
Well, here we are, and I always get so sad when I have to say goodbye to another guest. But before we do, I always like to ask, like, four more questions, and then I'm going to, you know. But if you could, if you were, let's just say, we had to go back in time 10 years from now, and you were to tell yourself that you were doing music in the future, and you were incredible, and you were on the radio, and people were listening to you and dancing to your music, what would you tell yourself 10 years ago about you here in the future?
You mean as advice, or I would...
Anything.
Or describing.
I'm talking about you show up, and then all of a sudden, bam, you're back in, you see yourself, and you have one moment to talk to yourself and say, hey, you should probably just do this. You should do this. You should give yourself some advice, like some life-changing advice.
I mean, that's pretty simple. I would tell myself, get your head together, focus on the right things, and follow your dreams, because you're going to be so much happier and your life is going to turn into a dream. This is the one thing you'll be missing for the rest of your life if you don't do it now.
Wow. That's what you would say to yourself.
Yes. If someone told me that, I mean, if myself told me that, it has to be someone I trust. But if someone told me that, I would totally
listen. Yeah,
should listen.
That's awesome. That's the best advice I've heard. That's good.
Thank
and I
you,
ask that
you.
Question all the time. I really, truly do. Now let me
it's
ask you
this.
It's
a great question.
5 years from now, I believe in the law of attraction. I believe manifestation. I believe that you can speak things into existence. So,
same here.
I'm glad we're on the same one accord. We're on the same wavelength here in the universe. So with that being said, 5 years from now, where would you like to see yourself on, let's say, the four core pillars in life? Love, happiness, health, and wealth, and also your music career. Where do you see yourself 5 years from now?
That's somewhat of a difficult question, because I really live in the now. And I take it like I do put goals and I set goals, but I set kind of short-term goals. So I make sure I tackle those before I get to the next level. Mm-hmm. But as far as bigger picture, I mean, I see myself just growing in the entertainment field and the music field, and just being able to sing, dance, inspire, and entertain others in any form or way possible. Mm. I would love to get on TV, you know, I would love to get on the radio.
Yeah.
More than often.
Yeah.
I've always actually had a dream to talk on the radio, so thank you for being part of that dream and having me here.
Anytime, you're welcome back. When you release your new single, we can definitely do another one for you.
I would love to come back. But yes, basically just growing and continuing to grow and just leaving a legacy with music and inspiration for other young artists to follow, or older artists, or just people in general. I want to leave a legacy, a motivating, positive, light legacy for people to be able to follow and get inspired by.
Beautiful. That's beautiful. Great words, great advice, and just very, very well said. All right. Is there anyone you would like to acknowledge for offering financial support or emotional support throughout this journey?
Well, financial support, it's all been me. I'm going to pat myself on the back.
You might as well. Shoot. And I always say, you got to believe in yourself before anyone else does.
Hey, inspiration, the best kind of inspiration comes from
self.
Within.
Self. That's right. That's right. Self-inspiration.
But as far as emotional support, obviously my mom and my family, but, you know, my mom is just more involved than the rest of them. A couple of my friends have been very supportive and with me on this journey. And then definitely my good friend Friday, Point Blank Beats, the online recording studio. I mean, everyone that I've been blessed to meet and that was part of this journey, I'd like to shout out. I can't think of all the names, but they know who they are. Let's put it that way.
Is there any last words?
Well, I just want to tell everyone to come to my social media, follow me on social media. I love connecting. I love going live and having deep felt, heartfelt conversations. You can find me again at only the number one, Zaina with a Z like zebra, all one word. And I'd love to hear from you. So definitely send me a message. Let me know what you're up to and keep on creating, whether it's music or ventures or anything that you have going on. Just keep on doing it and push harder and live your best life.
Thank you so much for being a guest here on the Afterwork Drive Show. And we deeply appreciate you here on 104.5. And you're welcome.
Thank you, BJ. I really appreciate you having me. And it's been a pleasure. And I hope to be back soon.
And you will, because I want you to remain and always remember, be positive, stay positive, and I'll see you in the future, okay?
Sounds good. Thank you so much, everyone, for listening.
Take care.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.